Peacock, Peacock, which is probably the worst possible name NBC could have come up with for their streaming service. I mean, what they could have just called it NBC Online, but Peacock is doing a new Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. And you're thinking, great, that was a fun show. I loved it. And it was entertaining. It was, is it a continuation like they did with Punky Brewster? Are we gonna, no. Hey kids, do you like Succession? If you do, you'll love the new Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
It feels like they're trying to kind of toe the line between comedy.
It really doesn't, though.
Like, now he has, like, a gang banger trying to find him to murder him?
Yeah. Yeah. Like, that whole, I got one little fight, my mom got scared. Right. We get to see that one little fight. And it's right. Like, holy shit. Oh, no,
except,
oh God.
It's really serious, and now there's a dude who wants to murder him.
There are guns involved. Oh no. Oh, okay. That, okay. Carlton?
I mean, I will say what is the family's last name? Banks.
Yeah, the Banks.
The Bankses seem happier to see him in this version.
Carlton seems creepy. Version,
he arrived and they were all like, the poor cousin. And here they're all like, hey, give me a hug.
Carlton is kind of creepy. With some subtle menace behind him. Uncle Phil looks like he's murdered someone. Uncle Phil is not big and jolly this time. He is like stripped down and like Yul Brynner going on. Like,
they got like a network TV Mahershala Ali for Uncle Phil.
Like, it's like, what? And there's like dramatic tension and shit. I'm like, what happened to... You know, you're worried if Uncle Phil throws Jazz out of the house, he's going to throw him into fucking traffic. He's going to die. And like, you're going to see the accident.
I think Will Smith is behind it.
Which is so weird.
So maybe this is the show he wanted to make in the 90s and they wouldn't let him. Maybe he wanted it to be a more serious type show, like a 90210.
This isn't like 90210. This looks like Riverdale.
Well, yeah, 90210 is kind of the Riverdale of its day, just without all the weird supernatural.
There will be weird supernatural. We'll find out the true meaning of the Prince of Bel-Air, the Dark Prince of Bel-Air.
The Half-Blood Prince of Bel-Air?
Yeah, something like that.
Ooh.
It's going to get weird.
Because, like, in the first version, like, the scariest thing closest to a ghost was just the white people. Like, the white douchebags at the private school they went to.
Can we not dark and gritty everything? Does everything have to be dark and gritty?
Even a few years ago... You weren't a little girl in the 90s, so you probably weren't super into Anna Green Gables like I was.
Nah.
I was all about Anna Green Gables.
They had a series back then, if I remember right.
Yeah, it was Canadian public television.
Yeah.
Did a miniseries, and it's great. And then they did Anne of Avonlea. They did all the books. A few years ago, Netflix remade Anna Green Gables, but they, like, dark and grittied it. They made her, like... a victim of child abuse and everything. Like, and I'm like, Anne of Green Gables is such a great story. It doesn't need it. Just let her be a dramatic girl with an overactive imagination in a small town that is not really ready for her toreador bullshit.
I don't.
Just let us have nice things. We need them so badly right now.
There's going to be a dark and gritty elf where he's like, you know, possessing people, trying to take over the planet.
I would watch that, though.
Eating cats whole.
Do you remember the episode of Alf with the Melmacian cockroach?
No, I
that
don't.
Every time they use, oh my God, this episode was terrifying. So they leave Alf home. I was a big Alf fan, too. They leave Alf home alone. And it turns out on his spaceship was a Melmacian cockroach, right? And every time they use like a bug killing product to try and kill it, it gets bigger and bigger and bigger until finally, like, it's like one of the ants from the swarm. and it's like chasing Alf around the house, trying to eat him. And in a, like a last resort, he sprays like the mom's perfume on it and it falls over dead.
So
but when you're a little kid, that giant cockroach is not terrifying, man.
So anyway. So yeah, I think that's...
all the whippersnappers are like, what the f*** was TV like in the 90s? It was weird.
It was incredible.
Don't even get us started on the puppet dinosaurs, okay?
That was just depressing.
It was weird. There's a reason we're like this.
Yeah. So anyway, let's get the intro going. Each week, Catherine, Radio Dead Air audience, but worldwide interwebs find all sorts of horrible stuff. Bring it back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck Is Wrong With You, for better or worse. And our very first one this week is, of course, the one everybody was throwing at us immediately tonight. We finally found out there is something that can, in fact, get you fired from the LAPD. Is it murder? No.
No.
Is it assault? No.
No.
No, no. What can get you actually removed as an officer of the Los Angeles Police Department? Come on. Can I please just copy this, please? Thank you. Thank you. Stupid computer. What? You ever do that on like a web link? You double click on it. It's like, what? You only want to highlight half of this? Okay, I'll highlight half of this for you. You didn't want to highlight the whole thing.
And it's the second half, which is useless.
Yeah, it's useless. LAPD officers ignore robbery in progress to catch a Snorlax in Pokemon Go. Now, I know what some of you are actually thinking here. How did they know they were trying to catch a Snorlax? How do they know specifically it was a Snorlax? Well, they have the entire thing on tape. Two LA officers were fired for ignoring a robbery in progress and instead trying to catch a Snorlax in Pokemon Go. During the officer's appeal, former LAPD officers Louis Lozano and Eric Mitchell were fired for, quote, willfully abdicating their duty to assist a commanding officer's response to a robbery in progress while playing Pokemon Go mobile game on duty. Incident happened April 2017, when Pokemon Go was still super relevant. According to court records, a patrol supervisor called Mitchell and Lozano to respond to an apparent robbery in progress. Several police officers left the scene of a homicide to respond to the call. Mitchell and Lozano, meanwhile, were in the area, but didn't respond to the call and instead backed down an alley and drove away. Just 5 minutes after Officer Lozano said, quote, screw it, to checking in, Officer Mitchell alerted Lozano that a Snorlax just popped up at 46 and Lemert. After noting that Lemert doesn't go all the way to 46, Lozano responded, oh, you know, what can I do? I'll go down 11th and swing up on Crenshaw. That way I can get to it. We got 4 minutes. For approximately the next 20 minutes, the DICVS, which is the recording system, captured petitioners discussing Pokemon as they drove to different locations where the virtual creatures apparently appeared on their mobile phones. On their way to the Snorlax, Officer Mitchell alerted Officer Lozano that a Togetic just popped up. It's on Crenshaw. So, even better. After Mitchell apparently caught the Snorlax, if you were worried, he got it. So don't worry.
Whew.
Exclaiming, got him, petitioners agreed to go get the Togetic and drove off. Mitchell said that he buried the Togetic using an Ultra Ball on it and was, quote, still trying to catch it after some time. Quote, holy crap, man, this thing is fighting the crap out of me, Mitchell said, according to court records. Holy crap, finally, the guys are going to be so jealous.
Increasingly, Pokemon is a language, like just a whole other dialect that I do not speak. You could say say any fucking nonsense word to me and tell me it's a Pokemon, and I would be like, yeah, okay, what kind? Is it like a fish?
Who's that Pokemon? I have no fucking idea. What?
Also, though, fuck these guys.
Fuck these guys! Because this wasn't an after the fact. This was a robbery in progress. That means someone was in a place they should not have been. You need to go. Yeah. You need to be, not Pokemon Go. Put that down. Put the, and they were recorded doing the whole thing.
Long before police had body cams, they had car cams.
I kind of feel a little embarrassed for these idiots.
No.
This is some car 54, where are you shit?
And also fuck the LAPD, because you cannot get fired. You can get fired for hunting a Pokemon, but not for hunting black people.
Right? That's a little weird. Isn't that a little weird? That's a little fucking weird. I have known people who have been like at like retail jobs who were like, oh, you can't do the Pokemon Go here. But there's the cops just like, oh, what the fuck? It doesn't matter. What are they going to do?
You don't even get to pee.
Yep.
When you want to. You have to ask permission.
Do you know that people come here?
And these guys are like, ah, fuck that robbery. They're probably fine.
Yeah, people come here from out of the country and they see our retail people and they can't sit down and they don't understand it. Because in other places, if you're at the checkout, you get a chair. You can sit while you're using the register. That's allowed. We're just barbarians here.
All these guys are like, no, there's a poop majoo half a block down. We gotta get it. Is that one of them? That's probably one of them.
There's a testicles over there. Let's go get whatever the fuck that is. That's probably a Pokemon. If it's not, it's going to be someday. All right, next up. Here we go again.
Make like Pokemon for adults, like the X-rated Pokemon.
Don't give them ideas. Especially as an AR game where you have to go out in public. You don't want these.
Yeah.
No. You don't want people tit hunting in public. Things will get bad that way.
But it'll keep us in a job.
Speaking of keeping us in, Jesus Christ, I can't believe we have to give the same PSA over and over and over. We must be at least 10 stories on this one now, if not more. People, you know that Santa is fucking fictional, right?
Again?
Man removed after being stuck in chimney of a home he doesn't live in.
Even if you don't know that Santa's fictional, you know that he's not you, right?
Well, you don't know. Maybe that Santa Claus hasn't kicked in or something, you know? Well, you know, maybe you murdered a guy in a Santa Claus outfit and you thought, now I have his powers. That's how it works, right?
If you're guiding your life by anything involving Tim Allen, you are doing it wrong.
It's like Highlander rules, right?
Even Buzz Lightyear isn't Tim Allen anymore. They replaced him with my sweet Babu because they're smart.
A man was in a tight situation when he got stuck in the chimney of a home he doesn't live in. That's really, really, that's what you went with. It's not even a good one. That's like meth lazy.
Yeah.
Montgomery County firefighters were called to remove a man from a chimney near Silver Spring. Approximately 24 firefighters were called to the home when the unauthorized man wedged himself in the chimney. Crews had to methodically remove walls and bricks from around the chimney in order to get the man out. He was taken to a trauma center with non-life-threatening injuries. I'm looking at that and I'm cringing myself. Because, Jesus Christ, look at the damage they had to fucking do.
Has J.K. Simmons seen that one? When you call your insurance?
Papa. No.
Are they going to cover that shit? Do they cover lunatic?
Do they make lunatic insurance? Because you know what? It seems like it should be popular in some places.
They fucking should.
Look, oh my God. That's so these poor people have a big fucking hole in their house because this idiot crawled down. You know he's not paying. You could sue him all the live long day. If someone is stupid enough to try and crawl down your chimney, they ain't got a dollar. They have
he
not.
He was probably breaking in to rob the place.
Yeah, they ain't got shit. This is because this is one of those nightmares. All right, folks, I don't think you quite understand this. A lot of younger folks really don't get this. If something like this happens, you're fucked. No one is going to make it right. The police aren't going to fix it. The guy who's responsible for it is not going to fucking fix it. Your insurance is, if you have it, is going to fight you on it.
Yeah.
Because
what category is it under? Act of God?
So just someday someone can come in and fuck up your entire life, and that's just going to happen. And you're just going to have to live with it. When you're 20, you think, but someone's responsible, right? And you learn over time. No one is. Shit just happens.
Think about how many people that are so young, they shouldn't be watching this show, are watching this show, and what we're doing to them.
We're preparing them.
Life is a hellscape of disappointment, kids.
We're preparing them. We're preparing. But yeah, smashing a window would have been more fucking effective. It would have taken less time. He's like, no, I'm going to be slick. No one's going to know I was here. Did you think you were going to crawl back up?
Chimneys aren't big, you guys. They're not that big on the inside.
No.
I don't know why people think they are, but they're not.
Cats get stuck in chimneys.
Yeah. Raccoons.
Possums.
They're not that fucking big.
I saw a video, it was on the Dodo, that an owl got stuck in one.
Oh.
Because it couldn't spread its wings wide enough to get back out. So they had to, go down and rescue the owls. There were two of them. They had to rescue them.
Babies.
Yeah.
Are they okay?
No, they're fine.
Okay.
They flew off like, fuck you, and they were done immediately. So, but yeah, this is, you can't fit in there. Dumbass. Like, you thought, oh, this could be the crime of the fucking century. Just break the window already. It would have been cheaper to replace. Now these people have to replace it.
They might have gotten out.
But fucking drywall work costs? Jesus Christ. Oh, they had to take the mantle down, too. Shit. Just.
That's going to be a pretty penny.
Shit.
Because also, that chimney's missing a wall now.
Yeah, you got to put up some plastic or you're just going to be losing all your heat out the fucking chimney.
And didn't the whole East Coast get
a
crazy winter storm this week?
Yeah, it's still fucking cold. It's like, what, 35 here, which is weird because it was like 70 on Christmas. Fahrenheit, folks. Fahrenheit. Today. If it was 70 Celsius on Christmas, we would all be dead. But
that's next year.
That's next year. So moving along, other countries that are not us idiots have actually mandated if you have to go into a place, you have to wear a mask. Because they're sane.
We have freedom.
To die. Some people, even when it is in their best interest, and I'm not talking their health, simply will not wear the fucking things. And you know what? Good. Because you're dumbass. Polish murderer on the run for 20 years arrested for not wearing a face mask. Police in Poland have arrested a convicted murderer who had been on the run for 20 years because it wasn't wearing a mask. Warsaw police say they detained the 45-year-old fugitive at a shop northeast of the capital. The man was stopped by police in the Blani district. I think I said that right. Because he didn't have a mask. And is now been transported to prison where he's due to serve a 25-year sentence for murder. Face masks are mandatory in all shops in Poland under the latest pandemic restrictions. All you would think if you are on the run for a capital offense. Fuck, you would be trying your best not to show your face in public anyway.
And all of a sudden, they're like, everyone has to hide their identity. You'd be like, Pater.
Right. You'd be like, no one will suspect me. I blend right in. But no. But no. What the? All you had to do. Look, if you're on the run from the police, job number one is to not get the attention of the police.
Drive speed limit, not have a taillight out, don't make any sudden movements. Like, you want to be invisible.
Right. You don't want to be, it's not like, I don't have to wear a fucking mask. I know my rights. You're right. You're going to jail. You idiot. Yeah. I don't understand how he's managed to survive 20 years without getting caught. But
right?
Because this guy seems like, really?
He doesn't seem like the brightest light on the Christmas tree.
He doesn't. I'm glad they got him, because fuck you.
But you French fries short of a happy meal, this guy.
It's so weird. This is not the first criminal who's been like, I ain't gonna wear no mask.
No.
You're in the commission.
Didn't we have a bank robbery?
Yeah, wouldn't wear a mask.
If there's a time when you should definitely want to have something on your face, it's like, when you're robbing.
This is a prime moment in history to get away with crimes and hide your, just disguise your appearance. No one's going to go, oh, there's a guy in the mask. We should call the police. No, everyone's going to be like, oh, there's a guy in a mask. Okay.
Fucking it up for your ego.
Yeah. Yeah. You can't tell me what to do. Yes, actually, they can. They have the guns. They can tell you what to do.
You know where they can absolutely tell you what to do? In prison.
Yes. There's someone else going to jail this week. Where is this? Philadelphia. This is kind of a... We've had this one before. This is the whole... If you're going to commit a crime, and I don't know why we're helping you. Maybe we were pitying. But if you're going to commit a crime, maybe, just maybe, before you show you do it, don't give them all of your information. when planning to rob sex toys from an adult store, it's best to avoid establishments at which you recently applied for a job.
Oh, honey.
And that picture is just, that says everything, doesn't it? 29-year-old man is behind bars on multiple criminal charges after he allegedly stealing $350 worth of items from a Pennsylvania business and threatening to stab the clerk who sought to stop him. Now, see, $350 stealing, that's, you're going to get arrested. But that's still in misdemeanor territory. It's when you jump up to, I'm going to stab you. Now you're in serious, just, it that bumps everything all the way up.
The thing, people that work in sex shops are impossible to impress.
Really?
They have seen everything.
Really?
They ran out of fucks so long ago because they have all the retail shit plus all the weird fetish shit.
Yep.
Like, you're not gonna scare or impress them with your antics. They're going to blink at you and keep drinking their fucking Starbucks.
According to a criminal complaint, Jacob McFarlane last week entered the Adult World Emporium in North Wales, a Philadelphia suburb, and walked out with a pair of masturbators, a $95.99 fleshlight model, and the Autoblow AI, which retails for $250.
What is that?
An adult world. Okay, we gotta pause. The Autoblow AI. The Autoblow's creators contend the 10-speed masturbator, which plugs into a wall outlet, quote, uses artificial intelligence to give you the perfect blowjob.
All right, now.
It's a robot dick sucker.
Tara? I don't think you should put your dick in anything that can, that's an AI.
It's robot that's dick sucker. Me.
I don't have a dick, but if I did, I wouldn't stick it in an AI.
Robot dick sucker. So, I mean, I know it's hard to meet people these days, obviously.
I mean, he was going to use the right tools for the job, which we always say. We don't usually feel like we have to tell you to pay for them.
But, you know, it's credit still real easy to get right now. It's not going to be by the end of the year, but it's still you apply for a fucking credit card. Pay that shit off or don't. That's another easy way of doing it. But
I mean, there's instructions online that you can make a fleshlight out of like some PVC pipe and like saran wrap full of jello. It's not ideal, but it's better than prison.
Flag on the play.
You can DIY that blowjob.
How?
Maybe not the AI.
How did you discover this?
I don't remember. Was it Lifehacker? I don't remember. It's just a thing I know. What I thought was funny was the instructions originally said a paper towel tube, and I was like, oh, that's just sad.
Oh, God.
If you don't at least need a pipe.
Also, you're now going to be, this is what you're always going to have a record for. When someone Googles your name, from now on, you're the dude who stole the robot dick sucker.
Yep. That's you.
And you had to get a fleshlight too, just in case you didn't like the robot dick sucker.
Just in case, yeah.
You wanted to do it the old-fashioned way.
And here's the thing, from the picture, it looks like this guy's a ginger. I don't know if you know this, bro, but we stick out. We're only 2% of humans. So, like, a face mask will not protect me from a crime.
No.
Because I have all of this. So, yeah, sorry about it.
Let's go more Pennsylvania.
Also, maybe don't give them your name, address, and social.
Right, don't apply for the fucking job. It kind of makes it easy to find you. Fucking idiot.
I mean, I guess he was planning to be working there and steal that stuff.
Skipped a step there, bro. From Lancaster, let's move right along, because it's just... We said last week, and this is another fucking car dealership, we said last week, you can just go along in your life, trying to just mind your business, live a normal, just everything's simple. And then from out of nowhere, you have no say in it, you can't stop it. Suddenly there's penises.
Suddenly penis.
Man goes to test drive car, ends up naked. Which I love how the headline ends up naked, like, his clothes.
You missed a few plot points there.
A Lebanon man is facing an indecent exposure charge after police say he walked into a car dealership completely naked. Mannheim Township police were called to the CarMax. Police say 42-year-old Horace L. Samuels, don't see a lot of Horaces these days, went to the business to get his vehicle appraised and test drive a new one. Okay. Every day. Authorities say during the interaction, Samuels went to his vehicle and came back inside the business completely naked. Officials say there were about 30 people in the business at the time. What the fuck? What the hell?
Hang on, I forgot something in my car. It's my dick.
You're just minding your own fucking business, and then suddenly, wait a second, I didn't pull my dick out. I'm sorry. I forgot. This is like the opposite of I forgot to put on pants.
Like, I know they tell you to not, like, wear really expensive stuff when you go to shop for a car.
Yeah.
so that, you know, they don't think you're, you know, you don't bring your most expensive purse. You don't wear your designer shoes because you want to try and get a deal.
Yeah.
You should, however, wear clothing.
Like it's not going to, that's, I don't think that's going to give, they're not going to knock 20% off for that out of pity. That's not how that works.
I mean, if it's crowded in there, somebody might knock 20% off of you.
Yeah. There's like, what? I don't understand. Everything was fine. Everything was normal. They're all like, okay, we'll get the paperwork filled out. We'll see you in a second. Hello. Things are different now.
Change the conversation that way. Nobody was going to say anything about that.
I think it's gonna...
Good news, you're pre-approved for a line of credit.
All right, the last one this week. This is going to be a swerve. I'm going to tell you. All right, you're gonna hear, see the headline, and you'd be like, "Well, I know what happens." No, you don't. This is a fucking saga. This one is amazing. All right, so let's start with the headline. Reverend Sheriff Deputy held naked man at gunpoint for hours during armed robbery. All right, so now you're already thinking about a whole lot of things. You're thinking, was this guy robbing people while he's naked? No, it's much weirder. And there's cryptocurrency involved. A former Brevard County Sheriff's Office Corrections Deputy held a naked man at gunpoint, filmed him for hours, forced him to sign a $30,000 contract, and threatened to send him incriminating video to his family and church. Now, normally, at this point, I would be...
But, the naked guy wasn't doing the robbery?
No, but okay, that's our first twist here. Now, normal, this is the point I'd be like, oh no, that's, you wouldn't do that to somebody. That's terrible. I'm not going to do the story. But wait, there's another twist to come around, okay? Let's get to the guy who's with the gun. Amity Robillard, Amity Robillard.
A weird name. Yeah. That came out of a randomizer somewhere on the internet.
Was arrested on charges of robbery with a firearm, extortion with a weapon, and false imprisonment with a weapon. Robbery of the firearms, first degree felony. Robillard entered a plea of not guilty. He remains jailed. Let's see. Okay, I want to get down to the details. The armed robbery took place November 19th at an Airbnb rental home. A 34-year-old Kissimmee man arrived at the home to have sexual relations with a 19-year-old Orlando woman. But after he... So, we've already gotten things going on here. Things are going on here. But after he exited the shower, Robillard emerged from behind a curtain, pointed two semi-automatic pistols at him, and held him captive for about 3 hours. Robillard ordered the man to sign a contract saying he agreed to pay Robillard $30,000, and he even arranged for a notary and the victim's wife to come to the home. Robillard also took $200 in cash and $450 from Cash App from the man, and told Orange County investigators that he and Robillard had been friends for a year, and that he had given poor cryptocurrency investment advice that led to Robillard losing $2,000 when the company tanked. But wait, there's more. The 19-year-old Orlando woman, Jerise Reischer, worked in tandem with Robillard to lure the man to the home. She was arrested December 8th on charges of robbery of the firearm, conspiracy to commit extortion. So there's a honeypot going on here. There's like... reverse and quick reverse, and this is like upstate, this is like lights off or noise, this is like noises off, only our version.
I mean, for a minute it sounded like, have you seen In Bruges?
No.
It's a great movie. It's a really good movie. You should see it. But Colin Farrell's character meets a girl and goes back to her apartment, and then like her boyfriend shows up to rob him, and that's kind of their gig. Huh. For a minute, it sounded like that. But no.
But no. Okay, look. First of all, no matter what you do, no matter how, if you get a notary, if you get it all written up and legal, and you cannot enforce a contract that was agreed to under duress.
Well, the notary, and she walked into the Airbnb with a naked guy and another guy holding.
All right, I just, do you need your stamp or anything? Do you need something to write on? You need a pen? I think there's one downstairs. You need a pen? No, I can't. Like, I can't. Just go that way. I got to stay here for a second. He might go somewhere.
What were you going to tell the notary? And the notary would probably know that that's not an enforceable contract.
No. And then it got the guy's wife there. Why was she there?
Like, that's a one-act play.
Seriously.
The notary walking into that situation. That should be like a little one-act opera somewhere.
Also, the fact he lost $2,000, so he thought he deserved $30,000? Look, sometimes you make a bad investment. Crypto is always a bad investment. Always. Unless you're trying to find a greater fool.
Scammed, and that sucks.
Yeah.
But this isn't the solution.
No, this makes everything so much worse. Everything here is terrible. Everyone's like,
how did the 19-year-old even get involved in it? Where did he find her?
I guess he hired her. Which, I don't know. Do you put out a Craigslist ad for that? Wanted a honeypot to help me trap a man and steal money from him. Flexible hours. Dental. You know, how the fuck do you... And now you're actually fucking thinking about it.
Trying to figure out where she fits in. This should be, you know that Twitter thread that went viral and became a movie? Zola? You don't know about that? There was this stripper and she did a Twitter thread about this other stripper that got her into this whole fucking mess. And it's a movie and the movie's really good. It just came out. It's called Zola. This should be the next one of those.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
At one point, Amity...
And it could be one of those, like, Pulp Fiction ripoffs where they tell the same story five times from everyone's point of view.
Videos on Robillard's personal cell phone showed him pointing a gun at the man who was sitting on a bed naked. Robillard also threatened the man's life multiple times, told him he would plans on killing him, cutting up his body, putting it in a garbage bag, and throwing it into the ocean for the sharks to eat.
Self-committing this crime?
Yep, he created evidence.
And this person used to be a cop.
Yep. It's amazing. Like I told you, like you read the headline, you're like, oh, this is our standard shit. No, it's not.
Should we just let the Gators have Florida? I think they'd be more responsible.
They're trying their best to take it already.
Like, just let Disney and the Gators, Godzilla and Kong, that shit out for dominance.
Well, currently it's a Godzilla and Kong between the pythons and the Gators. Humans are just in the way. Whoever wins, they lose. So, you know, good job.
But neither of them are voting for Ron DeSantis. So really?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Oh, the comments. I heard where you guys get political.
We don't give
a fuck. We're old. We don't care.
We don't give a fuck. Eat a dick. We don't care. So yeah, I guess the first thing we learned is...
January, eat some ass. We don't care.
I don't even know what we could say, what we learned about this one. Don't judge a story by its headline, I guess. Jesus Christ.
Don't trade crypto in Florida?
This is a saga. I don't even... Wow.
This is like the Florida version of, like, Dynasty. Or, like, a telenovela. This is the Florida version.
We've learned that, you know, if you're you don't, why do you suddenly need to inject nudity into an everyday situation?
Oh,
I don't know.
This isn't porn. If you show up naked, it's not going to, an orgy is not going to break out.
Yeah. I mean,
you probably don't want it to.
Listen, if you're hearing 70s slap bass, it's just in your head.
You can't just whip your dick out.
Wow. No, that's just going on in your brain, dude. You're having a stroke. We've learned if you're going to steal the robot dick sucker, don't give them your name in advance, because now everybody knows you stole a robot dick sucker.
If it's an AI, it can be hacked, right? Like, could you just bite the dicks off hundreds of men at the same time? Because if so, I am investing in this company.
Smash cut to someone on a keyboard. I'm in! We've learned that maybe sometimes, even if it hurts your ego, lean into the mask. It might help you in other ways. Is that,
yeah,
that
you might think you don't want to do that, but that's just pride fucking with you.
We've learned, I don't know how you aren't learning this. We keep telling you this. You can't fit down the chimney. You can't. You might be looking down that hole and going, oh no, I could do it. No,
you can't do it.
You can't. They thought of that when they built the motherfucker.
Yeah.
And now here comes the fucking fire department. You dumb shit. And finally, we've learned what can actually get a cop fired. And it's playing Pokemon Go on duty. So maybe we should encourage more of them to play Pokemon Go.
A cap? All cops are Pokemon trainers. You have the right to remain silent while I show you my Pokemans.